You can start, please.
Okay. So, hello, everyone. I am Ritumoni Sarma, and I am from IIT Delhi. So, I'll teach modules, mainly linear algebra over rings. So, main topic is modules, and mainly modules over a commutative ring with unity. And mostly, this will be linear algebra over a ring, and this ring is actually commutative ring with unity. Okay, so let us first, and I'll not recall much, but I expect students to recall that notions of fields, which perhaps we have already had in some of the lectures, and vector spaces, which is defined over a field. So I'll just generally say that recall fields and vector spaces. So this is kind of must, because this is very helpful, and which we know the notions, etc., how this is to be modified and why now it is different in module theory, that we are going to comment time to time. Okay. Suppose V is an abelian group. And which is denoted additively. What do I mean by this? The operation in the group is denoted by symbol plus, which is very standard in group theory also. Abelian groups are often written like that. Although in case of cyclic group, we prefer to use multiplicative notation. But here we are going to use additive notation. Okay. So then I write end V. This notation stands for endomorphisms of V. I'll just write, this is the collection of maps from V to V, which are group homomorphisms. V is a group and F is a homomorphism from V to V. So we collect all of them. So this collection, since it is a homomorphisms are from V to itself, they're called endomorphisms. And we are collecting all of them in this. And then we are saying that it has got an algebraic structure. Then NV is a ring. With respect to the following operations. Participants can suggest me what are the operations. Anybody? What are the operations? Anybody would like to suggest? What is the addition operation?
Function addition.
Addition component of wise addition. Yes, sir.
Okay. So if I have two endomorphisms, I want to add them. So this sum, I'm just adding their images.
F of E plus G of E.
Right. And I want to multiply F with G. How will I multiply them?
Composition.
It's composition.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
So if I here I have a map from V to V, and another one. This. So I can compose, but there are two compositions. Other way composition is also there, G with F. So you choose which one you want. Okay. So so this ring has got an identity element, multiplicative identity, that means unity. So namely the identity map. Right? This takes any vector to itself. This is the identity map. Is the multiplicative is the unity. And NV need not be commutative. Okay. So we'll see maybe example. So say V equal to Zn. Okay, so this is a very good example for us because we are going to look into Zn quite a few, in future also as examples of several other things. So in this case, what is endomorphism? Can you again suggest me? What are all endomorphisms? Linear, group homomorphisms from Zn to itself. Anybody would like to suggest? So n by n matrices. So n by n matrices with coefficients from Z. So how will I get this? You have done in linear algebra for vector space of dimension n. So this part you can recall. So if I have a vector space, say F is a field and V is the n-dimensional vector space, then what are all linear transformation? Maybe you had a different notations. Linear transformation from V to itself. So this has got a structure and it is n by n matrices, coefficients coming from F. So this is similar. Okay, so this is also an example, right? So in this case, this is also a group homomorphism, right? So, but here, you see here, I'm talking about vector space homomorphisms, right? So in what is in the red color? Okay, so another example. Maybe we take V equal to this group, Z upon 2Z, direct sum with Z upon 3Z. Okay, maybe if we take Z upon 2Z, it is also a group. What are all endomorphisms of Z2 to Z2? Maybe I remove the other component, just this one. Endomorphisms of Z upon 2Z. Anybody would like to suggest?
What are Z to Z?
Same?
Yes, sir. Z upon 2Z, yes, sir.
And what are the elements?
Identity and zero.
Right, identity and zero. So now, if I do replace this by Z upon 3Z, will I have the same answer?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so maybe I write as a third example. Then what is the answer? I just want you to have an idea about this, how this ring structure is. So how do you think this one? Any suggestion? Any suggestion? Wrong is also fine. Can I say this is maybe I slightly change it notation, cross here. So this is product ring I'm writing. Okay, so do you please think this one? Think this one, whether it is how to go about this one. Okay, and then try to find the structure endomorphism of Z mod say 4Z with Z upon 6Z. Okay, so you can try this as an exercise. Okay. Okay, so let me just talk about now what is the meaning of module. Let R be a commutative ring with unity. Okay, so this definition, it makes sense even otherwise. Commutativity is not required. Unity is also not required, but now we are forcing here that unity is there, but commutativity is not required as such. But since we are going to do only over commutative ring with unity, so I am assuming this to start with. An abelian group V is called an R module if there is a ring homomorphism from R to NV such that the unity goes to the identity element here. You please remember that in case of ring homomorphism, multiplicative identity may not be in the ring, first of all. If they are there, domain and codomain rings have got the unity, multiplicative identities. They may not be taken by the map homomorphism. Homomorphism may not take identity element to the identity. So therefore, it is a condition. Right, this is a condition. So, for any vector in V, I'm thinking this like a vector, but it is an abelian group. So any element of the vector group V, and any element of the ring R. So R. Under this map, to start with, maybe I call this map as phi. So phi R is what? Is an endomorphism of V. So I can apply this endomorphism on V and I get an element belonging to V. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
So we use notation, we write RV to indicate phi RV. So normally we do not write this big of notation, so many parentheses and notation of phi. So we are going to write simply RV. Okay. Any question here? With this notation, we have R, any element coming from the ring, V1 plus V2, any two elements coming from the group. Since R acts as an endomorphism, it's a homomorphism, so R of V1 plus R of V2, right? So, but I'm not going to put a bracket actually, so I'll not write this bracket, I'll remove. I write this way. And R times S, I have two elements coming from R. Then I want to multiply to an element of the group. Then this is same thing as I multiply first by S and then by R. Okay, maybe I put a parenthesis here. And identity element of the ring multiplied to any element of the group should give me V only because it acts as the identity map. Similar again, the sum of two elements in R, when I apply on V, an element of the group, then it is the sum of R applied on V as S epsilon. Okay, so thus an R module can be thought as an abelian group V with a scalar multiplication. Sorry. R cross V to V. Any pair like this goes to RV, okay, such that star holds. Star holds. So star has got several equalities here. This is my star. So before I write here, maybe I say that for all R S belonging to R, V1, V2, V belonging to V, and together I am putting in star. Okay, so alternatively, therefore, I can say that if I have an abelian group V, then this abelian group is an R module if there is a scalar multiplication, that there is a map from R cross V to V such that these equalities hold, and this should hold for every pair RS in R. And this vectors, I mean, group elements V1, V2, V coming from the abelian group. Okay. So these two, I mean, you can think this as the definition, and then you can get the other definition. So these are, you know, this is just seeing the same thing in two different ways. So this is not a problem as such, I think. But if you have any questions related to this, please ask. Okay, maybe this is easy for you to do. Okay, so if R is a field, then an R module is a vector space over R. So then this is the same thing. Okay, so so what we are talking about is a generalization of the concept of vector spaces. Modules are generalization of vector spaces. Every abelian group is a Z module. Okay, so this is another step. So what is the first one? So we noted here that vector spaces are modules and abelian groups are also modules, but they are Z modules. Vector spaces are modules over a field. So how do I know this? Because if N belongs to Z, for N positive, what I'm going to do, I'll multiply N to an element of the abelian group V just by adding V n times. And for n negative, what I'm going to do, I'll add minus V, maybe like this. Minus n times, because minus n is positive. Okay, and n equal to zero, of course, zero V is zero only. So this defines a Z module structure on an abelian group. Okay. So if W is a subgroup of the R module V, then W is called an R submodule of V. If what I have R applied on W, must be in W for any W picked from W and any R picked from R. Okay, so this is a condition for a subgroup of an R module to be an R submodule. This is how we define R submodule. The subgroup we know, so I am assuming already this is a subgroup, okay? It's not just a subset, a subgroup. Okay. Example. So ring R itself is an R module. Is it fine?
Yes, sir.
Because I can multiply an element of R to an element of R itself, right? And this is the scalar multiplication. So that's not a problem. And what are R submodules?
Ideals of R.
Right.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Ideals.
R submodules of R are precisely are the ideals of R. Okay. Two, Rn. So this is, I have n full product, or like maybe I write like this, that if I think of set, I'll write R cross R cross R, but I'm thinking as an abelian group, an additive notation. So I'm writing like this. So n components. Okay, so this is an R module. R submodule. Like example of R submodule, I'll just say this one, that if ij is an ideal of R, then the sum of ij, j equal to say 1 to n, so here j is from 1 to n, so this sum is certainly a subgroup of this Rn. And in fact, this is an R submodule. So when we are discussing modules, the notation less than symbol is used also for submodules. Like, you know, for subgroup, we use this notation. For subspaces, we use the notation of less than symbol. I'm talking about this symbol. So the same symbol is used for submodules, okay? Every subgroup of a Z module is a Z submodule. Okay. So this should not be a problem. So we'll come to maybe more examples. Yeah, another example, maybe I just quickly. Right, want to write, say ZX is a Z module, is a ZX module, right? Because ZX is a ring, and every ring is an R module. R is an R module that I know. So in this case, can you identify a subgroup which is not a submodule. Okay, so I want you to identify. I mean, you can tell me even now, is there a subgroup of ZX which is not a ZX submodule? Anybody would like to answer this question?
Z of integers.
Right. Yes. Yeah. So, example, Z is certainly a subgroup of ZX. And why it is not a submodule?
So because scalar multiplication is not there.
Right.
Like X, yes.
X to 1, this is X, and it does not belong to Z. 1 belongs to Z, but this scalar multiple is not in there. So this statement that subgroups are submodule and is not true generally, right? For Z module, this is nothing, because Z modules are nothing but abelian groups. So therefore, 3 is that way, generality, I mean, tautology. Okay. Next, we have just talked about modules, submodules. Then we are going to talk about maps of modules. So homomorphisms, same terminology. Suppose V and W are R modules. Then a group homomorphism. So I have a group structure always in V and W. So talking about referring to that, then a group homomorphism F from V to W is called an R module homomorphism. If F applied to scalar R coming from R multiplied to V, this should we go to R times FV. So this is the same definition as in linear transformation, right? So it is already preserving addition because it is a group homomorphism, right? So therefore it is preserving addition and it is preserving scalar multiplication also, right? So which is, which in case of in vector spaces, in linear algebra, we called such a map to be a linear map. So here also you can call them linear maps. So these are whom we are calling R module homomorphism. Okay. So this should hold for every element in R and every way coming from V. All right. So next, maybe let us see an example. From ZX to itself, psi. So I'll send FX to GX times FX. I'm multiplying FX, any element of ZX. ZX, what is ZX? It consists of polynomials with integer coefficients, polynomials in X with integer coefficients. So, and it forms a ring, and ZX is a ZX module. So this map as ZX module I am looking at it. So this map is a module homomorphism. So here GX is fixed. Okay, so it is not difficult to verify at all. So if I have HX times HFX, I want to add them. Yeah, so you can verify. I mean, it's okay, maybe. By definition, I have to simply multiply gx to hx. This is a generality, right? In case of ring, I know that this is a homomorphism. Okay, so maybe I just again now define kernel. So that definition is not required. I shall just write in a proposition because definitions are same. If psi from V to W, V and W are R module homomorphisms, V and W are R modules. So psi, if psi is an R module homomorphism, then image psi, that means the range of psi. Maybe I write range, the range of psi, which is psi v, and kernel of psi, same definition, whether it is group homomorphism or vector space and linear transformations, this is the same. It consists of elements coming from V, which when I apply psi, I should get zero. These are our submodules of W and of V respectively. So I know that they are subgroups already, that range and kernel, they are already subgroups of respectively the codomain group and the domain group, so that they are submodules. What is to be verified? So please tell me what is to be verified now.
Scalar multiplication, yes.
Right. I need to check whether it is there closed under scalar multiplication. So I'll pick an element. So an element, suppose psi v belongs to the range. That means what? That is v is coming from v only, right? Any element in a range looks like this. So what do I need to check? I need to check whether r times psi v is again in the range. But I know that this is equal to psi of rv. So therefore, this guy is the image of an element coming from v. So, and that is, it is in the range. I hope this is fine.
Yes,
that's all I check for range to be a submodule. And then, suppose v is coming from kernel of psi, that is psi v equal to zero. And then I need to check whether psi of rv is zero, but psi of rv is r times psi v, which is zero, right? So I know that r is an endomorphism takes zero to zero. So psi times r must be zero, right? So that I never talked about, but since r is an acting as an endomorphism of abelian group, so it takes zero to zero. So therefore, scalar multiplied to the zero element of the abelian group is always zero. Okay. So that RV is also in the kernel of psi. So that's all. These are to be checked. All right. Next proposition. Because I'm directly going to the proposition, because we have done already linear algebra and group theory in BSc and also in MSc first year. Normally it is done. Okay, this proposition, if W is an R module, sorry, R submodule I want, R submodule of V, V is an R module, then the quotient group V upon W, because W is a subgroup of V, so I can talk about the quotient group, is an R, is an R module under the map, under this operation, that R coming from capital R, a scalar, to be multiplied to this coset, sorry, V, W plus V, and simply R times V. Another notation that I'll say, that if you are comfortable with this notation, how I need to multiply R to V bar, an element of the quotient, is I multiply first R to V, and then I find its coset. This is the same thing, but written in a different way. And so this is the map. This is the scalar multiplication under which this abelian group becomes an R module. And secondly, the map, which we call quotient map, from V to V upon W. So which is often written as eta or pi. So I'm writing pi. This is pi is more standard later. Is an R module homomorphism. Okay. So V map to V bar. This is a group homomorphism, and this group homomorphism is in fact an R module homomorphism. I have R modules in the domain as well as in the codomain. So therefore, we want to know whether this is a R module homomorphism, and answer is affirmative. So what do I need to check here? If I need to prove at all anything in this proposition, what are the things that I need to do? Proving is easy. You can prove, write a proof, right? But what is that we need to prove? Anybody will tell me?
First, we need to define, we need to check the well-definedness of the multiplication.
This one, yes. So what am I supposed to do?
We will take another representative.
Right, so W plus V, say equal to W plus V prime, right? V and V prime are coming from V. Suppose they are equal. Then do I get, the question is that W plus RV equal to W plus RV prime. Am I right? This is what to be verified for, yes, this operations to be well-defined. Okay. So, and this is true because this will tell me that V minus V prime is coming from W. Right. This is again very standard. And therefore, R V minus V prime is in W, because W is an R submodule. When I multiply by scalar, it is again there. It's closed under scalar multiplication. And then I can use distributive law that this is R V minus R V prime. So, and this one now tells me that W plus RV is equal to W plus RV prime. Okay, so is that enough?
Yes, sir.
This is enough. So this is already an abelian group. So well-definedness having a map from R cross an abelian group, say abelian group, is not enough for for it to be scalar multiplication or G to become a R module. Right? We have certain conditions. For example, identity element, right? When I multiply one to it, it becomes same. So it is obvious here. I can say that it, see that it is obvious. Similarly, you verify the other properties. So is it not required to verify?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So what this says that the scalar multiplication is well defined. Okay. So verify other properties. Okay. So, and this map, eta, which is a surjective group homomorphism, I know this already, right? We have learned this is a surjective homomorphism. Surjective group homomorphism that I know. So why this is a module homomorphism, that is perhaps obvious that when I apply this to any R times V, I write RV, and this is how we define scalar multiplication. So this is, okay. So this is also not difficult at all. So now, isomorphism theorem. Some of them will be discussed in the tutorial. I'll just write down the first one. If psi from V to V prime, so I have R modules are V and V prime. And psi is a surjective R module homomorphism. We can write in short or abbreviate homomorphism as HOM. And W is the kernel of psi. Then the quotient module V upon W is isomorphic to V prime. Okay, so this we know that V upon W is isomorphic to V prime as groups. So they are isomorphic groups. That is the first isomorphism theorem of group theory, but we are applying it for abelian groups. So here we are saying that this is in fact an R module homomorphism, right? So what is that? So just let us write down. This is a statement. Just let us write down that how will I define a map from V upon W to V prime? So I'll simply take W plus V to psi V. So we know that this is a good one, good map. And so what is that to be verified? Psi bar R W plus V, which is psi bar W plus RV equal to psi RV R psi V equal to R psi bar applied on W plus V. Okay. So I hope this is okay. Just that it preserves the scalar multiplication. Other things I don't need to prove. Okay. And that this is a surjective map is true because psi is surjective, right? So all possibility of psi V is in the image, in the range of psi bar. So, but psi is surjective. So psi bar is surjective. And what is the kernel of psi bar? Is the singleton W, the zero element. Or zero module. Okay. W is a zero element. So this is psi bar is an isomorphism. Of R modules. I don't have to say what is an isomorphism of R modules. A homomorphism which is bijective. R module homomorphism, which is bijective, is called a R isomorphism, R module isomorphism. Next, correspondence of submodules. If psi from V to V prime is a surjective homomorphism or R module homomorphism, module is shortened, abbreviated as mod, homomorphism as hom, with kernel equal to W, then there is a bijective correspondence between R submodules of V prime and R submodules of V containing W. Okay. So psi is a surjective homomorphism. So we are saying if I know the collection of submodules of V that contain W, then I know the all submodules of V prime. Namely, I'll take their images under the homomorphism psi. Okay. So such this correspondence was there for group theory also. Everywhere subgroup is replaced by R submodule, right? Subgroup word is replaced by R submodule. Okay, so let us just quickly recall what is it. So if I have maybe less than symbol W, a submodule of V containing W. Sorry, U, a submodule of V containing W, the kernel of psi. Then psi of W is containing psi U and containing psi V. But psi V is what? V prime, because I am assuming psi to be surjective. And psi W is what? W is the kernel of psi, so this is the zero element, zero module. So U psi is a submodule of V prime. Okay, so that this is a submodule, one should verify, and it is very clear that if I have R times psi of small u, then this is psi of R u. And Ru belongs to U, therefore Psi Ru belongs to Psi U. So therefore Psi U is a R submodule. I know that this is a subgroup of V prime, so it is in fact a R submodule of V prime. So this is the first thing. All right, so if U is a submodule of V prime, arbitrarily chosen, then the inverse image. So often I have seen that many students find this one difficult to understand, although it is very simple. So I am just bringing this. If you understand, it is fine, no problem. So when I write like this, psi, I am not assuming that psi is invertible. Okay, psi inverse U is a set, whether psi is injective, bijective or not. Okay, psi inverse A U always makes sense. Psi inverse of an element always makes sense. What does it? It is the collection of all elements coming from the domain which are going inside U. Or U is singleton, which is going to that, is equal to that element. So I'll write this one as all those elements in V, which when I apply psi, it should belong to U. So this is V. And this is U. The other one is U. Okay, this collection. And then it is not difficult to see that this is a submodule. Okay. So again, I mean, you can think this is an exercise, easy exercise. Exercise. Show that. Anything you find difficult, you can ask in the tutorial or in my lecture also. It is fine. So that's so that this is a submodule of what? V. Okay. So this you just verify.
This is a tutorial problem as well.
Okay, that's good. So who are you? Can you tell your name?
Sir, I'm Manoj.
Okay, okay. So anyway, you will be in the tutorial. Good.
Yes, sir.
Okay, thank you. So this guy is a submodule and it contains the kernel. Sine inverse of zero is nothing but the kernel, which we call kernel, which is W. So therefore, this is contained inside sine inverse of U. Okay, because U contains zero. Sine inverse zero is contained inside sine inverse U. That's what I am saying. Okay, so what we have learned from here, that if I start with a submodule of V prime, its inverse image is a submodule of V containing the kernel. And if I have a submodule of V containing the kernel, then by simply applying psi, I have a submodule of V prime. Okay, so what is remaining, that why this correspondence is bijective? That means, if I have two different submodules and then their images are different. Okay. That is the only thing to be left now. So will you do this one yourself?
Yes.
So what is remaining? So if V1 not equal to V2, submodules of V, then of course, containing W, both containing W, then psi V1 is different from psi V2. So this is what I'm asking. Or conversely, V1, V2, not equal, submodules of W, not W, V prime, I should write, V prime, then psi inverse of V1, not equal to psi inverse of V2. Okay. Okay, so this you see why. I mean, they're not difficult, maybe easy, but spend a little time and just identify. Any problem, you just let me know. See, understanding something is maybe not be difficult, but no, that for me to understand whether you are following is difficult unless you tell me. Okay, either the reason or you say that it is okay to me. So then I'm kind of, okay, fine. I can go ahead.
Yeah.
Okay, so now let us move a little bit to the linear algebra part. Do I have any statement here, another? Okay, so maybe one more statement here I just attach. S is under the map, above map, S is associated to S prime in the above correspondence. What do I mean by this? That kernel S is inside the containing the kernel and is a submodule of V, and S prime is submodule of V prime. And S is psi of S is S prime. Okay. So I'm picking like that. This. Then what can I say about this one? I can think of the quotient V upon S. I can think of the quotient V prime upon S prime. So can I say that these two are isomorphic? So this is my question. So anybody would like to discuss this? So V, I want to map to I want to map to S prime plus psi V, which is nothing but actually psi of S plus psi of V. What is the kernel of this map? So this is from V to V prime upon psi S, that means S prime.
Sir, are you saying something?
Sir, are you speaking? Or...
I also can't hear him.
He's not muted actually, but still we are unable to listen to him. Sir, are you able to listen to us? So I'll just talk.
Right, so determinant is therefore defined like this. So, and the same definition now we are applying, which we learned before. There's nothing new as such in the definition. So an interesting thing is that determinant satisfies this property. Determinant of product of two matrices A and B is product of their determinants. So this continue to hold. Yeah, so I'll make a few words and maybe, you know, prove a statement which will be helpful to understand why this should this holds even when I replace in numbers by elements coming from a commutative ring, maybe in the next discussion. So I'll stop here because our time is also over. So at least try the exercises, and tutorial will be tomorrow, and I have a class also before that.
Tutorial is today only.
Oh, tutorial is today. Okay, that's good. Okay, fine. So tutorial is maybe after 15 minutes from here.
Right.
Okay. 12 minutes. We'll start.